Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I am going to compare the basic brokerage charged by top brokerages of India. Those are like Zerodha, and I have considered icici direct. Actually they share equal number of customers kind of. Recently Zerodha broke into few parameters beating icici direct, so I am considering those both for comparison, and few of America's top brokers and investment bankers and their brokerage charges I am trying to compare. So this video is not exact or precise comparison, because it won't be possible, because their considerations have various considerations are there, and their situation, their laws and their trading styles are actually completely different. But still, to extend our understanding horizon and to understand various international markets and their to improve their understanding, I am making this video. Okay, so this is the website of Zerodha, where it shows zero brokerage for delivery trades. So it doesn't charge any brokerage for NSE or BSE if you buy it into delivery any stock, and it is flat 20 rupees for any intraday equity and FNO trade. In that also, for equity trading, intraday trades, it takes rupees 20 or 0.01%, whichever is lower. So it is around 20 rupees or lower you can consider for Zerodha. And for ICICI, there are two basic plans depending on your turnover and your choices. But actually it has a very different kind of calculation. Up to particular amount, it charges you around 0.55 flat brokerage for iSecure plan. That is, I have opened it, and if you increase your volume, it goes beyond crores or particular 50,000 rupees amount, etc. For various calculation, it starts reducing. For margin and margin plus, it is around 0.05. so overall you can consider it is in the range of 25 to 35 40 rupees for overall trading and kind of purposes for options and currency also. So okay, so we will consider it as 20 rupees, and for ICICI it is 20 to 40 50 rupees. Okay, now we will check into America's top brokerage houses. I have open website of Charles Schwab International. It is American broker plus big banking solution provider of America. It has so many branches in America. Actually, there is as such no ranking for the top brokers in America, but you can consider the top by their various basic parameters. So those are like, you can check here, you can see here E-Trade, Schwab, then Fidelity Investment, then TD, Ameritrade, and then Vanguard. It is not mentioned here, so I'll show you their basic charges. Actually, their basic charges are here. If you are trading into stock for online trades, it charges you around $5, that is around 350 rupees. Sorry, considering 70 rupees per dollar, so it will be around 350 rupees per trade. Okay, and if you are taking a broker assisted trades, that is calling and trade and kind of etc., so that is 20 rupees for Zerodha. But I guess they are providing brokerage services here, so it is even more for that additional charges. That is $25 for broker assisted trades for stocks. Then there is a special platform over there, that is what I understood. Actually, Schwab ETF OneSource. There are various distributed or created ETFs are there. Those are traded by Schwab OneSource platform. So there are $0 charges is there. And for all other ETFs, actually in America there are so many ETFs are there, means real estate trust ETF, then so many big stocks also have their ETFs trading there. Their volumes is also huge. So that is around $5 for same like stock, and $25 extra for broker assisted trades. And then for offshore mutual fund, transaction fee is $0, and short term redemption fee is around $50. Okay, and then for option, it is for online trade $5. I don't know how they have given this breakup, but it shows $5 around plus $6.65 per contract, and $25 extra for broker assisted trades. And for various bond kind of things, it is for preferred stocks and REIT, it is around $5 same. And for bond, $1 per bond, and you have to take minimum 10 bonds, so it will be $10 for bonds buying. Okay, and same $25 extra for Charles Schwab on broker assisted trading. Okay, there is no minimum balance for so most of 90% of the brokerage houses in America don't require or charge any minimum amount that you need to keep. But there are few brokers like Vanguard, etc. They want you to maintain around a few ETFs. Those are distributed by Vanguard, etc. So I'm not sure about all this info, but overall what I have understood from these websites and info I'm sharing with you, please correct me for my misinformation or understanding in comment section. Okay, here's a small comparison between Schwab E-Trade, Fidelity and TD Ameritrade. It is provided on Charles Schwab and Company Incorporation US website itself. For online trades, it varies from $5 to around $7 between Charles Schwab and E-Trade. Others charge $5, $7. Okay, then for options, it is $65 to $70. $0.65, that is around you can say that is 170 to 200 rupees for Indian terms, and $0.75 for E-Trade. Futures per contract, it is flat around $1.5 for E-Trade and Schwab, and for TD Ameritrade broker it is $2.25, that is higher. And then there is one clause or kind of offer for Charles Schwab broker. It says that if you are not satisfied with their service or any product, they provide you a satisfaction guarantee clause. If you are not satisfied, you can return. They can refund you whatever you have spent. Also, they can work out to resolve your issue, whatever you have. Okay, and there is few additional pricing that is mentioned here. Is that it's all about that is mentioned above. $0 for Charles Schwab ETF one source, and basically for stock it is around $5, and for futures it is $1.5, and $0.65 for options per trade. And there is also service of margin borrowing. It is not like leverage trading in India. It is actually like kind of you must have observed in Zerodha like brokers where you can pledge your shares and get some money for trading. Here you can get same money kind of for buying also. Okay, this was all about comparison of intraday of $5 for American brokers versus 20 to 40 rupees for Indian brokers, and $0.65 for American brokerage house, and compared to ₹20 for Indian brokerage houses. Okay, so it may appear that American brokerage houses are charging more or kind of on upper end of charges, but if you compare their earning and their overall trade structure, I don't think it is too much, because generally whatever understanding I have, if you are earning $7,000 to $8,000 in America, so it won't be that much charge. That is what I personally feel. It may be costlier for somebody else. Okay, so this was all about comparison between Indian brokerage charges compared to American US top brokerage houses. I'll be making more videos on covering various aspects of other countries, various parameters, so that to improve your understanding horizon and to my also. If you like this video, you can click on like. If you don't, you can click on dislike. You can click on share to share with your friends on Facebook and WhatsApp, etc. You can click on name of Share Market Friend channel and go on videos. There are so many videos for you. Okay. Thank you for listening. Share Market Friend.